Hello there. Welcome to Green Patch, home of Blinky Bill. I'm Mr. Wombat, and this is my house. You'll find all sorts of games here. Oh, and if ever you need some help, just click on me. Click on this, and I'll read you a story. Click on this, and you can play along with the story. Click on this, and I'll read you a story. Blinky Bill and the gang were surprised to see Mr. Rabbit sitting outside his burrow in his rocking chair.
What are you doing out here, Mr. Rabbit?
Asked Blinky.
There's no room for me inside, said Mr. Rabbit crossly.
No room? I'll have a look,
said Blinky, and he went in. Using the mouse, click around the page to find hidden surprises. To turn the page, move the pointer to the bottom right-hand corner of the page and click when you see the hand.
Are you absolutely sure there's no space inside?
There must be enough room for a mouse.
Those poor rabbits. It must be uncomfortable for them inside.
Is it tall enough for me, Blinky?
Inside the burrow, it was a very tight fit.
It's all these children,
said Mrs. Rabbit.
Someone's always falling out of bed. Oops, there they go again. I know,
said Blinky.
We'll find you a new place to live.
Hello.
We need a much bigger place to live.
Oops. Next morning, Blinky and the gang went down to the lake. They were looking for somewhere for the rabbits to live. Everyone they met wanted to help find them a new home.
Would they wish to live in a pond like fish?
I don't think so.
I think it's top to live on the hop.
Maybe the rabbits would like to live here.
Would they like to live on a log like a frog?
Probably not.
Would they like to live in a tree like me?
Probably not.
We must find somewhere that is best for the rabbits.
There's gotta be a place that has enough space.
Not far from the lake, they found a cave in the rocks.
Do you think this'll do?
Asked Splodge.
It's awfully dark,
said Nutsy, doubtfully, peering in.
Come on, Marcia, have a look,
said Blinky, tying a rope around Marcia's waist.
You're the bravest, Marcia.
It was very dark inside the cave, and Marcia hadn't gone far when she heard a groan.
Help!
Yelled Marcia.
There's ghosts in here!
Oh, don't be silly,
said Blinky.
There's no such thing as ghosts.
I'm a stalactite, and I hang on tight to the ceiling.
Are you sure it's safe, Blinky?
There's nothing to be scared of, Marcia.
I'm so scared.
Oh! I'm a stalagmite. I sit on the floor and wonder if stalactite might fall on me.
Despite Marcia's fears, Blinky told the rabbit family about the cave, and the next day the gang all helped the rabbits carry their furniture through the bush. Each little rabbit helped carry something. Mr. Rabbit carried his rocking chair.
Everyone, the cave's this way.
Hang on, gang! Wait for me!
Mr. Rabbit was delighted with the cave. He took his chair inside and sat down to scrape the carrots for dinner. Mrs. Rabbit was sweeping the floor when she heard a groan.
What was that?
She asked.
This is a great book. I thought I heard something.
I love carrots.
One of the rabbits went to the next cabin to investigate the noise. He was looking up at the stalactites when he heard a groan. Startled, he looked around, and there he saw five sets of glowing eyes.
Ghosts!
He cried and ran away. The next day at sunset, Blinky found the rabbits camping down by the creek.
Why aren't you in your new home?
Asked Blinky.
It's haunted,
said Mr. Rabbit.
A ghost stole my rocking chair.
Extraordinary! This I gotta see!
Exclaimed Blinky.
Where will we live?
How long do we have to hang around here for?
A ghost stole my rocking chair.
Blinky crept into the cave. He was surprised to hear someone laughing.
Ha! Fooled him properly, didn't we, Ma?
Said a voice.
Yeah, Danny, we did,
said someone else. Blinky crept nearer the big cavern, and there he saw the Dingo family. Ma Dingo was sitting in Mr. Rabbit's rocking chair.
Fooled him properly, didn't we, Ma? Ha! Fooled him properly, didn't we, Ma?
It's so damp in here.
The next day, in Gloop's cafe, Blinky told the gang what he'd seen.
We've got to scare those dingoes away,
he said.
We've got to pretend to be ghosts ourselves. We'll trick them like they did the rabbits.
Hey, Gloop! I'll have a scary soda.
Wow! Nearly scared myself.
How can we be ghosts?
This will scare them.
Ooh!
Ow! Ow! Ooh, ow! Oops!
How can we be ghosts?
What's that Blinky up to now? Ooh.
That night, the gang dressed up as ghosts and went into the cave. They howled and rattled the rabbit's pots and pans and groaned loudly. And the dingoes, frightened by their own trick, ran away.
Extraordinary,
said Blinky. Well, wasn't that a great story? If you think you can do it, you can try the memory game by clicking on the book with question marks on it. Click on this, and I'll read you a story. Well, hello again. When you move your mouse around the screen, you'll discover all sorts of things to do. I'll read you a story if you click on this book over here. There are a couple of puzzles on the ground and a memory game you can do after we've read the story. Oh, yes, and I've got a special surprise for you. Just click on the projector over there and I'll show you some wonderful slides of some of my Australian animal friends. If you've had enough, well, you know where the door is. So, have fun now.
Welcome to the puzzle page. Using the mouse, click on a character to begin.
Whoa! I've gone to pieces. Please put me together. It feels good to be whole again.
Oh, I don't believe it. I've fallen apart again. Help me to become one again. That's much better. Thanks.
Oh, wow. This is worse than breaking a nail. Oh, what a day. Can you help me get back together? Oh, well, thanks. Now let's see if I can stay together.
Now this is very uncool. I've been segmented. Can you fix this? Way cool. I'm one dingo to go.
Oh, I've gone to pieces. Can you get me back together? Again?
Can you put me back together? That's more like it.
I've hopped myself into pieces. Can you put me back together? Oh, geez, thanks. It feels good to be a complete kangaroo again.
Oh, dear me. I need fixing. Can you put me back together? you. I feel much better now.
Can you reassemble me? I'm much more together now.
Welcome back. Now.
Welcome to the painting page. Using the mouse, click on a character to begin. Paint with the paintbrush tool and choose a colour from the palette. Click, hold, and drag to move the scenery and other fun objects with the hand tool. Paint with the paintbrush tool and choose a colour from the palette.
Welcome back. Now.
Click on any one of the objects surrounding Blinky to play the quiz. Click on Mr. Wombat if you want to leave this page. Who are the characters in Blinky's gang? Using the mouse, click on the character you think is in Blinky's gang. And if they come to life, you've found the right one. Blinky has 5 gang members.
That wasn't too hard. I'm Blinky, and of course I'm in my gang.
Well, you've made me come to life. I'm Nutsy, the cutest member of Blinky's gang.
Well, I am glad you chose me because I'm Massia, and I'm the only marsupial mouse in the gang.
You guessed it, I'm Splodge, the biggest member of Blinky's gang.
A significantly good choice. I'm Flap, clearly the brains of the gang.
Well done. Now why don't you try another memory game? What animals can you see on the screen? Using the mouse, click on the names of the animals you can see. Frilled-necked lizard.
Yes, that's right.
Koala.
Extraordinary.
Emu.
Yes, that's right.
Pelican.
Hooray!
Well done. Now why don't you try another memory game? Most stories have a beginning, middle bits, and an ending. Using the mouse, can you click and drag the puzzle pieces above and arrange them to tell the Ghost Cave story in its correct sequence? The rabbit family had no... Blinky's gang searched to find a bigger place for the rabbits to live. A cave was found for the rabbit family to move into. Blinky discovered that the dingoes had disguised themselves as ghosts to scare the rabbits. The cave was thought to be haunted. Blinky's gang scared the dingoes away. Yes, that's how the story was told. The rabbit family had no more room in their burrow. Blinky's gang searched to find a bigger place for the rabbits to live. A cave was found for the rabbit family to move into. The cave was thought to be haunted. The rabbits were frightened away. Blinky discovered that the dingoes had disguised themselves as ghosts to scare the rabbits. Blinky's gang scared the dingoes away, and the rabbits finally got their new home. Well done. Now why don't you try another memory game? Some of Blinky's friends have lost their name badges. Can you match the names below with the characters above? Use the mouse to click on a name badge and drag it onto its owner. Danny Dingo.
Hey, cool choice. I'm Danny Dingo.
Mrs. Rabbit.
Yes, you found my badge. I'm Mrs. Rabbit.
Nutsy.
I'm so glad you found my name. I'm Nutsy.
Mr. Rabbit.
Quite a good choice, for I am Mr. Rabbit.
Well done. Now why don't you try another memory game? What are some of the sounds you heard while enjoying the story? Using the mouse, click and drag the sounds you heard and put them in the ear.
Oop. Oop. Yes, you heard that one.
Oop. Oop.
Yes, you heard that one.
Oop. Oop.
Yes, you heard that one.
Oop. Oop.
Yes, you heard that one. Didn't quite hear that one. Maybe try another.
Oop. Oop.
Yes, you heard that one.
Well done. Now why don't you try another memory game? Choose a word that describes the story best of all for you. Happy, exciting, scary, silly, clever, fun. Silly. So you found the ghost cave story silly. It must have made you wonder, what was it all about? Well done. Now why don't you try another memory game? Choose a word that describes the story best of all for you. Fun. Clever. Happy. So, you found the ghost cave story happy. It must have made you feel good. Well done. Now why don't you try another memory game? Can you remember what moved on this page? Using the mouse, click on the words that describe the things that moved. Fish.
Extraordinary!
Are you watching? Because here it goes again.
Would they wish to live in a pond like fish?
Frog. Are you watching? Because here it goes again.
Would they like to live on a log like a frog?
Splodge.
extraordinary!
Are you watching? Because here it goes again.
I think it's top to live on the hop.
Nutsy. Are you watching? Because here it goes again.
We must find somewhere that is best for the rabbits.
Eyes, saltbush. Oh, not that one. Try another. Eyes. Are you watching? Because here it goes again. Well done. Now why don't you try another memory game? The words on the bottom of the screen describe some of the things you can see. Using the mouse, can you click on all the words that describe things that have the colour green in them? Hill.
Yes, that's right.
Grass. Shrubs. Well done. Now why don't you try another memory game? This sound is made by which of the animals on the screen? Using the mouse, click on the animal you think is correct. Here's the sound again. Good choice. Is exactly the sound a fruit bat makes. This sound is made by which of the animals on the screen? Good choice. Is exactly the sound a dingo makes. This sound is made by which of the animals on the screen? Good choice. Is exactly the sound a cockatoo makes. This sound is made by which of the animals on the screen? Good choice. Is exactly the sound a bushfly makes. This sound is made by which of the animals on the screen? Good choice. Is exactly the sound a mosquito makes. Well done. Now why don't you try another memory game?
Welcome back. Now, what would you like to do next? Click on this and we can sit back for my special slideshow. All right now, is everyone comfortable? Because I'm about to show you some slides from my past. Now, let's see if I can make this old projector work. Now, who can recognise this little fellow?
Oh, I don't believe it. Where did you get this? How embarrassing. It's me.
Yes, Flap, it is you. As a very small baby platypus, not too long after you hatched from an egg. And you haven't changed a bit. Now, this next one is another one of the gang as a baby, but you're going to have to look very closely to see if you can find him.
That's Mum, isn't it? So the baby in Mum's pouch must be me! Extraordinary! Well, I must say I was cute before I even knew it. Well, I think you looked gorgeous, Blinky.
Yes, well, moving along. Now, the next one should be someone you may not have met before. One of the more secretive bush friends. And this fellow is known as a couscous.
Oh, geez, Mr. Wombat, she looks so fluffy and white. You sure she's not related to a polar bear?
Well, you should know that some humans thought the couscous was a monkey, but really, it comes from the possum family, and they can be found living in the northern tropical rainforests. and this makes their colour even more mysterious. But if you thought the couscous was white, I'll bet you never thought that echidnas could be white as well.
Oh, you mean my cousins? I've never seen a white one.
Oh, wow! Did it just see a ghost or something?
Boy, it's the strangest thing I've ever seen.
No, no, no. This chap was a friend of mine when I was a youngster. He was the life of my gang in those days. Every now and again, for no particular reason, a baby from a family is born with their skin coloured white, regardless of the colour of anyone else in their family. It's called being albino. Anyway, the next one is of a very cheeky fruit bat I once knew. Now, he didn't want me to take this photo, and I caught him blowing me a raspberry.
You've got this one upside down, Wombo. Here, let me fix it.
Blinky, I think you're wrong. All the bats I know always hang around this way. Don't you remember from the cave?
Yeah, sure, Splodge. But it would be good to see his tongue poke out the right way up. Uh-oh. So what do you think of that?
Oh, come on, Blinky! You're spoiling Mr. Wombat's slideshow! Ah! There's fire on the screen!
Now, Blinky, that's enough.
All right. I think I've fixed it. Wombo? Is that you as a baby?
I don't know how that one got in there, but yes, that is me when I was a mere pup of a wombat. Oh, and Blinky, don't call me Wombo. Now, where's the next slide? Well, if it isn't Danny Dingo's dad. Now, there was one great dingo. He helped save quite a few lives in the Great Fire of 42. You know, I'm sure somewhere inside that scheming Danny Dingo, you'll find a heart of gold passed down from his dad. Now, the next slide should have you chuckling, because it's of a kangaroo that can climb trees.
Kangaroos can't climb trees.
I guess there are still some things for you to learn, Blinky, because this is a tree kangaroo living up to its name. These agile fellows are found in the northern tropics and all the way into the highlands of New Guinea. And if you thought it was strange to see a kangaroo climbing a tree, then you'll be even more intrigued by the next slide. What has ears like a rabbit, a nose like an echidna, and a name like Blinky's?
Oh, wow!
What is it? Look! This is the bilby, a member of the bandicoot family and a very graceful creature that lives in sandy burrows. Maybe this is why their ears resemble the rabbit's. Now, the next slide is for you, Splodge. It's your dad, when he was the boss of his clan. I can't really remember if he was calling the gang over or if he was pointing at something.
Looks to me like he's found a flea.
Oh, come on, Blinky, don't make fun of my dad.
Now, you two quieten down, because we've come to the last slide. And it's a very impressive photograph of Gloop's great-great-granddad that no one has ever seen before. It can only be described as a work of art.
Where did you find that, Wombo? Gloop's great-great-granddad looks more like a dinosaur than an emu.
Well, Blinky, I had to hedge my bets on whether to show it in the first place. Anyway, that's all for now. I hope you enjoyed seeing some of my friends. It always makes an old wombat feel good to see his friends again. Oh, and Blinky, one last thing. Don't call me Wombo. Welcome back. Now, what would you like to do next? Well, thanks for dropping in. See you next time. Bye now.